were able to claim that they represent Judaism.
Y los sionistas lograron proclamar que ellos representaban al judaísmo.
And also Britain gave them, the Zionists, through the Balfour Declaration and so forth, the British Mandate, they gave them basically control in the Holy Land.
Inglaterra también les concedió el control absoluto de la Tierra Santa.
But prior to that, universally, every rabbi stood in opposition.
Pero antes de eso, todos los rabinos se oponían a ellos.
So, as Rabbi Cohen, who was in, at the beginning of Zionism, he passed away in 1933, I'm quoting him.
Va a citar al rabino.
The Zionists are dead limbs of our people, which causes the entire body to rot. They are dead limbs, you know, limbs are hands and foot.
Los sionistas son un miembro de nuestro cuerpo que está muerto y que causa que todo nuestro cuerpo se comience a podrir.
Rabbi Cohen is somebody who all Judaism, in every synagogue you'll find his books because he's a codifier of Jewish law.
En cualquier sinagoga van a encontrar las escrituras del Rabino Cohen.
Nobody can refute that this is a master in Judaism.
Nadie puede refutar de que él es un maestro del judaísmo.
And neither all the many, many others who are here.
Y ninguno puede refutar a ninguno de los rabinos que aparece ahí.
They all opposed Zionism.
Todos se oponen al sionismo.
And from day one, the Jews demonstrated against Zionism.
Y siempre los rabinos se manifestaron en contra del sionismo.
And our rabbis were assassinated. They were murdered.
Y nuestros rabinos fueron asesinados.
Maybe the first famous martyr was not even a Muslim or an Arab. It was a Jew.
El primer mártir no fue un árabe ni un musulmán, fue un judío.
In 1924, there was a famous diplomat. His name was Dr. Yisroel Dayan.
En 1924 hubo un importante diplomático.
And he was a diplomat in Denmark, and there's a statue of him in Denmark. He was very friendly with the king of Denmark.
Claro, en Dinamarca, que incluso tiene una estatua en Dinamarca hecha para él.
He decided to become a religious Jew.
Él decidió ser un judío religioso.
So he thought that meant to become Zionist, so he moved to Palestine.
Y él pensó que eso significaba convertirse al sionismo, así que se mudó a, se cambió a Palestina, se viajó a Palestina.
But because he was serious, he was searching the truth.
Pero porque estaba buscando la verdad.
He almost immediately got attracted to the chief rabbis of Palestine.
Inmediatamente se acercó a los jefes rabinos de Palestina.
At that time, that was his name was Rabbi Zonnenfeld, Rabbi Yosef Zonnenfeld.
En ese tiempo se llamaba Robert Joseph
Zonnenfeld, a blessed memory, a very holy man.
Un hombre santo.
And he became his right-hand man.
Y se convirtió en su mano derecha.
The British wanted to force the Jews in the 1920s to be registered under the Zionists.
Y los ingleses intentaron forzar a todos los rabinos judíos y a todos los judíos a convertirse al sionismo y registrarse en el sionismo.
And this Dr. Dayan, because he was a gifted diplomat.
Y este diplomático, muy inteligente.
He knew many languages. You can Google him. He was a poet. He was a very
era poeta, intelectual.
Famous person. He was able to extricate the Jews from being forced to be registered in the Holy Land under the Zionists.
Fue capaz de convencer a algunos judíos de no registrarse bajo el nombre del sionismo.
But even imagine the audacity. The Zionists come from Europe. They come all of a sudden, new people. The Jewish community is living there hundreds of years.
La audacia de los sionistas que vienen de Europa a un lugar donde los judíos han vivido durante miles de años.
They spit at God in the Torah.
Y escupen a Dios en el Torah, en la Torah.
And these old holy men, Rabbi Zonnenfeld, and the Jewish community should have to register under the Zionists.
Y estos hombres santos, rabinos, religiosos, deberían registrarse bajo el sionismo.
But thank God he was able to accomplish
that
should happen.
Que él logró no hacer eso.
And he said that he's going to go to the British Parliament.
Y dijo que iba a asistir al Parlamento británico.
And present the case of the Jews.
Y presentar el caso de los judíos.
That Zionism is false. They have no right to Palestine.
Que el sionismo era falso y que no tenían ningún derecho sobre Palestina.
The Zionists told him and they warned him, if you are going to continue, we are going to kill you.
Y los sionistas le advirtieron que si continuaba con eso lo iban a matar.
And so they did. In July 1924, they shot him cold-bloodedly in front of a hospital in Jerusalem.
En julio de 1924 le dispararon al frente del hospital de Jerusalén.
There's pictures of his funeral procession. There's the stories of him. It's very well documented.
Está muy bien documentada su historia.
Since that day till today,
hasta el día de hoy,
religious Jews
remain
in total opposition to the existence of the state of Israel.
Se oponen a la existencia de Israel.
And we demonstrate constantly in Palestine.
Demonstramos constantemente en Palestina.
And we have no guns. We're not militant.
No,
nobody can accuse us.
Armas. No nos pueden acusar de ser violentos.
It's a fact that we don't carry arms, that we do not kill, we are not militant. And still and all, they brutally beat us out, all the religious Jews.
Y aún así nos agreden brutalmente.
They arrest them.
Nos encarcelan.
We have many, many pictures. You can go to our site, NKUSA.
Tenemos muchos registros fotográficos que pueden ver en nuestra página web.
And you will see from every single day Jews are beaten, they are arrested,
que los judíos
they harassed.
Son encarcelados, acosados.
But wonder of wonders, in the media, nothing. Nobody knows this.
Increíblemente, nadie en los medios conoce esto. Nadie lo da a conocer.
They are looked at as the patrons, as the protectors of the Jews, the very good people who are here to have my back. To protect me from who? From the Arabs.
Claro, las mismas personas que proclaman ser los protectores de los judíos, de los árabes, son los que agreden.
We have demonstrations of tens of thousands of people.
Hacemos demostraciones con miles de personas.
And we would have hundreds of thousands more if people would not be so intimidated and afraid
of the attacks. Y habría
cientos
de miles más si no existiera el temor de las represalias que sufren. Por parte del sionismo.
In New York, we have tens of thousands of people demonstrating because we have a very large, concentrated religious Jewish community.
En Nueva York existe una concentración enorme de religiosos judíos y que constantemente están en demostraciones.
If you will come to New York, right across from Manhattan, the largest Jewish community, the most concentrated religious Jewish community.
En Manhattan.
There is not one single Israeli flag.
Y no hay ninguna sola bandera de Israel.
There, from that community, we go out and we demonstrate. We have our own synagogues, we have our own stores.
Tenemos nuestras propias tiendas, sinagogas, nuestras escuelas.
So we go every year, many times to Manhattan, with tens of thousands of people demonstrating.
Y siempre vamos
for
a
the
manifestar.
UN, in front of the Israeli embassy.
Al frente de la embajada de Israel.
But in California, in Chile, in any other place of the world.
Pero en California, en otras partes, en Chile.
A Jew knows that if he will speak out against Zionism, he will be targeted.
Un judío sabe que si habla en contra del sionismo, va a ser oprimido.
So, unfortunately, the vast numbers of Jews who are anti-Zionists do not speak out.
Por lo tanto, hay un gran número de judíos que son antisionistas y que no sacan la voz.
But invariably, in any part of the world, if you go to Australia, Melbourne, his uncle, my colleague here, Rabbi Rosenberg's great uncle, is a rabbi in Melbourne, an anti-Zionist, a beautiful community.
En distintas partes del mundo, en Australia, como es su tío abuelo, que es un rabino.
If you go to London, Stamford Hills in London, the most religious Jewish community.
En Inglaterra también.
You barely find an Israeli flag. They're anti-Zionist.
No encontrarán una bandera de Israel.
In Montreal.
Antisionistas.
In Montreal, because
Montreal.
It's a very strong community, also you find demonstrations against Zionism.
También encontrarán demostraciones.
And so you find any place, the more religious the Jew, the more anti-Zionist.
Mientras más religioso sea el judío, más antisionista es.
Because it's simple, Judaism is diametrically opposite to Zionism.
Porque simplemente el judaísmo es contrario al sionismo.
Judaism believes in God.
Judaísmo
may sound
cree
funny,
en Dios.
But that's what it's all about. They don't believe it. They have a facade, they have a rabbinate, a chief rabbi, it's a facade, it's window dressing.
Claro, y a su vez habla de que existe esta máscara del Estado sionista donde tienen sus propios rabinos y es toda una máscara, es toda una falsa.
Our hearts cry with the suffering of the Palestinian people.
Nuestros corazones lloran con el sufrimiento del pueblo palestino.
We talk about it in our synagogues, we talk about it in our gatherings.
Hablamos siempre esto en nuestras reuniones, en las sinagogas.
We are humiliated and frustrated because the people around the world think the more religious, the more you support the state.
Nos sentimos humillados porque las personas piensan que al ser más religiosos, más apoyo deberías darle al Estado de Israel.
Nothing could be further from the truth.
Y no, nada se aleja más de eso.
You can see again when the Zionists make their Fifth Avenue in Manhattan, they make their parade on the Independence Day. You can all see who comes. You won't find the very religious there. Never, never.
Cuando en Manhattan celebran ciertos feriados judíos de independencia, no van a ver a ni un solo judío religioso.
So, therefore, we can only urge everybody that
solo podemos incitar a todas las personas.
Do not feel guilty.
No te sientan culpable.
To speak up against this occupation.
De hablar de esta ocupación.
You're not anti-Semitic.
No eres antisemita.
And in fact, the first thing is we believe a person, it's the Almighty who accomplishes. So first we urge everybody to pray to God to bring a speedy and peaceful end of this occupation.
Lo primero que nosotros les pedimos es que oren por un desmantelamiento pacífico del Estado de Israel.
Entire free Palestine.
Y liberar por completo a Palestina.
And secondly, as we feel it's obligated to stand up and speak because the people in Gaza, the people in Palestine, the people in refugee camps.
Y dar voz porque la gente de los campos de refugiados, la gente de Gaza, de Palestina.
In Jordan, in Lebanon, in Iraq, wherever you go where the Palestinians are residing, they're living in squalor, they're suffering.
Están viviendo el sufrimiento.
We went to Gaza, it's indescribable.
Fuimos a Gaza y es indescriptible.
Besides physically, they're lacking in everything that's necessary.
Ellos les hace falta todo lo que es necesario para vivir.
Emotionally,
emocionalmente,
they are attacked. Every child is deformed because their psyche is messed up because of this terrible occupation.
Todos los niños tienen daños psicológicos irreparables por esta ocupación.
So we have to stand up and clearly be clear about it. Don't say I'm anti the Jewish state. Say no. The Zionist state of Israel.
Y deben ser claros al decir que ustedes se oponen al Estado sionista, no al Estado judío, porque no es un Estado judío, es un Estado sionista.
And we won't fall prey to your intimidation. We know it's not Judaism. Don't try to call me an anti-Semite.
Y claro, y no nos vamos a dejar intimidar porque ustedes nos llaman antisemitas, sino que somos antisionistas.
And God helps sooner nowadays, God with his compassion should bring this, just like USSR, the United Soviet Socialists, didn't allow religion. God, in a minute, it disappeared. Who would have believed?
Así como grandes imperios o la Unión Soviética se terminó, nosotros también pensamos que el Estado de Israel puede acabarse algún día.
Our rabbis keep on saying, in the Torah it says, God says in the Torah, it says, how long will you rebel against me? You will not be successful.
La Torah dice, cuestiona, que ¿cuánto tiempo más te rebelarás contra mí?
Esto
no puede ser exitoso.
The state will end. We are certain the state will end. The state of Israel will end.
El Estado de Israel va a acabar, de eso estamos seguros.
We don't know when. We pray to God.
No sabemos cuándo.
And soon in our days.
Pero oramos por ello.
And so let us stand up and work for this cause of Palestine.
Así que levantemos nuestros corazones y trabajemos para eso.
Thank you.
Alguien más allá y Hacemos rondas de tres preguntas mejor, así que van con él ahí atrás y con su compañero.
Dígamelo a mí y yo lo traduzco.
Él dijo durante su exposición que el Inglaterra le había aceptado la creación del Estado de Israel por cortesía al primer presidente que tuvieron, que fue Weizmann. Lo que se sabe en la historia, que en realidad no fue por cortesía, sino que fue por netamente por interés de Inglaterra, porque tuvo presiones de dos partes. Una, el señor Weizmann era un oficial de la Armada Británica y era químico, y desarrolló un nuevo explosivo que era más potente que la dinamita. Y le dijo al gobierno inglés que él entregaba la fórmula siempre y cuando se creara el Estado de Israel. Y por otra parte, la segunda presión fue del dueño de la banca europea, el judío Moisés Amcher, que...
¿Judío Moisés?
Moisés Amcher, yeah, que era judío alemán, eskenazi,
yeah,
que le prestó plata a Inglaterra y a Alemania en las dos guerras mundiales. Sin embargo, corto el piso. Sin embargo, le pidió a Inglaterra, le dijo, yo le presto toda la plata que necesita.
¿Le condonó la deuda en el fondo?
No, le presto toda la plata que usted necesita. Él no regalaba nada, él estaba a interés. Siempre y cuando reconozcan el Estado de Israel. Y así lo hizo Inglaterra. Y más encima lo nombró caballero y ahora se llama Lord Rothschild, que es la familia más rica del mundo.
Voy a traducir al tiro, si no.
Para las otras personas agradeceríamos que fueran preguntas, que fueran breves también para facilitar la traducción de que tiene que hacer nada.
Okay, so he's asking, when you said that England gave as courtesy to the first president of Israel, the possibility of the creation of the State of Israel. But in fact, he says that it wasn't for courtesy, but for interest, because of pressures. First, because Weizmann was an official of the army, and he was a navy. He was a chemist.
And
he invented something that was stronger than the dynamite. Yeah. So he said he would give them the formula.
Exactly.
If they gave them the permission of the creation of Israel, but also because of the owner of the European bank, Moises Amcher, who lended money to England in the two wars, and he told them that he would lend them all the money that they needed if they recognized the State of Israel, and he is now recognized as a Lord?
Mr. Lord Rothschild.
Well, with the help of the Almighty, I hear your narrative that he demanded it, but in the narrative that I read, they promised Chaim Weizmann, he provided them the dynamite, and he invented a system or whatever, after the war, they asked him how they could repay him, and they said they gave him this paper declaring that they look favorably, the Balfour Declaration, they look favorably upon a Jewish state. Could be the narrative the way you say.
Claro, ellos conocen otra versión. La versión fue de que él les dio la fórmula de esta arma, ¿verdad? y que en compensación de este favor le dijeron cómo te podemos compensar, y ahí él pidió la creación del Estado de Israel.
In the scheme of things, this is the point that I wanted to bring out. You know, whether it's the way,
pero sea you, como sea, historia.
The point is only that the Zionists were foreigners. They were interlopers. They were a people from a different country.
El punto es que los sionistas eran extranjeros. Eran de otras partes del mundo.
And they came as enemies to take over my religion.
Y llegaron como enemigos a apoderarse de mi religión.
And steal the land from the Palestinian people.
Y robarle la tierra a los palestinos.
And against the Jewish people who were there in Palestine, and they had the support of Britain. That's all that I wanted to bring out.
Y lo que quería recalcar era que llegaron con el apoyo de Inglaterra.
There's many
hay
issues.
Hay muchas narrativas y hay muchos temas.
I know there's many other issues, reasons, you know, that we can delve into. Unfortunately, time does not allow, because there's
money. Tiempo no podemos hablar. Pero
that they want to stabilize, of course, like from the Western world, they want to design the Western world wanted to stabilize and force in between the Arabs because
así
of oil.
Así como también existe la narrativa del occidente que quería tener cierto poder dentro del
but I just wanted to bring out the point that they are not what they say they are. They are not representing not the religion.
Solo quiero
not,
decir que no son lo que ellos dicen ser, son extranjeros.
And not rightful to take the land.
Y no tienen derecho de detener la tierra.
And I want to mention that although there's like many people from the evangelistic Christians that they support and the creation of the state.
Y quería recalcar que hay muchos cristianos evangélicos que avalan la creación de del Estado de Israel.
Especially after the Holocaust, Jews,
después del Holocausto,
millions of Jews were killed.
Que fueron asesinados tanto.
And
judíos.
Many, most, everybody means well. They mean they have good hearts.
Y todos tienen un buen corazón.
And they sympathize. They feel the suffering of Jews.
Y simpatizan con el sufrimiento judío.
And of course they buy the narrative of the Zionists that God gave it to the Jews.
Y por supuesto se creen la narrativa que el sionismo ha difundido.
That is exactly why we are pleading with these people, these good-hearted people, that you are being misled.
Es por eso que nosotros también nos enfocamos en informar a estas personas que están siendo engañadas.
It's not what God wills. It's not what God wills.
No es lo que Dios quiere.
And it's far from doing a favor for the Jews. It's only exacerbating anti-Semitism.
Y no es un favor hacia los judíos, sino que está exacerbando el antisemitismo.
Yeah. I remind myself another issue. I'm being constantly accused of denying the Holocaust.
Constantemente soy acusado de que yo niego el Holocausto.
That's just another dirty, vile.
Es otra mentira sucia.
Movement of Zionism,
y estrategia
basically.
Del sionismo.
In fact, as I mentioned, the majority of my family was killed in Auschwitz.
Y como antes dije, la mayoría de mi familia fue asesinada en Auschwitz.
My father escaped from when the Nazis came into Hungary, but his parents were killed in Auschwitz.
Mi padre escapó en Hungría, pero sus papás fueron asesinados en Auschwitz.
And I could go on and on. My father-in-law, who just passed away a few years ago, was in Auschwitz, and he used to wake up in the middle of the night till his last days almost. Screaming from terror.
Claro, y hasta sus últimos días despertaba en la mitad de la noche gritando del terror.
But that's the audacity.
Esa es la audacia.
Of these people who don't have a God and the Torah as a moral ruler, as a yardstick to you know.
De estas personas que no tienen, que no siguen los mandamientos de la Torah.
That they, as I mentioned, Chaim Weizmann, and I have a whole book, Holocaust Victim Accused.
Tengo un libro entero.
That speaks about how the Zionists colluded with the Nazis.
Habla de cómo los sionistas se coludieron con los nazis.
They thwarted the efforts to save the Jews. My grandparents died in Hungary. Most of my relatives died in Hungary.
Casi todos mis familiares murieron.
There's a book called Perfidy from Ben Hecht.
Hay un libro de Ben Hecht.
Perfidy is the name of the book. Perfidy.
Perfidy.
And it speaks about how there was a Zionist, one of the government members of the Zionism, a very well known. His name was Rudolf Kastner.
Y habla como Rudolf Kastner.
He was the head of the Zionism, of the rescue mission, or whatever it was called, the Zionist movement. One of the heads in Hungary.
En Hungría.
And it was proven.
Fue probado
that he worked with the Nazis.
Que trabajó en conjunto con los nazis.
In order to save his relatives, he duped, he told, he let the Jews think
para salvar a sus familiares y
that they're not
that
they're not
judíos,
that they're not being led to death, they're being led to camps not to be to slaughtered. And he knew what was happening. He worked with the Nazis, and this was proven.
Él fue probado de que él trabajó con los nazis y él ayudó a engañar a los judíos al decirles que estaban siendo trasladados a otros lugares mejores cuando en verdad estaban siendo llevados a campo de concentración.
He was accused of this in Israel, Greenwald, a writer accused him of this, and this Kastner,
un escritor lo acusó de esto.
Took him to court, this Greenwald, for libel, you know, for accusing him of false things.
Y claro, en corte lo acusaron de
for defamation, de, you know.
Por difamación.
And the court said that he was right, this Greenwald, and this Kastner, who was one of the heads of Zionism, he worked with the Nazis and the Jews in Hungary. They were being led to. They didn't know what was happening to them.
Yeah.
And again, there was a great rabbi, Rabbi Weissmandel. He wrote a book. He was a head of anti-Zionist rabbi, and he lived in New York actually in the last years. He created a lot of Jewish schools in New York. His name was Rabbi Weissmandel. He secretly went to the Nazis, and he accomplished that they were willing to sell the Jews of Hungary, not to kill them, for an amount of money. And the Zionists,
bueno, que fue probado de que muchos judíos fueron engañados y llevados a campos de refugiados, yeah. Y existió un rabino en Nueva York que secretamente se reunió con los nazis y descubrió que los nazis estaban dispuestos a vender a los judíos.